In this video, I'm going to show you how to run and configure the Sprint Data Neo4j example, which is called Cineast. You can find it here on the GitHub repository. The address is here. And then if you navigate through the directories to examples and then Cineast, and it's there. I had a little bit of trouble getting it going, and I really wanted to start off with it so I could have a look at the code and get started with the Spring Neo4j. So to download it, you can just click on the zip and then save it somewhere convenient. I'm just going to put it on my desktop. Obviously, if you've got Git installed, you can just use git clone from the command line and use the address here. But I just find this way simpler. So then from my desktop, I just extract the zip file. Now the repository contains everything to do with Spring Data Neo4j, so we only need the, I'm going to delete the zip file now. We only need the example. So in here, it's Spring Data Neo4j examples. And there is Cineast, the simple version of the example. I'm going to copy it and just put it in where I keep my projects for Eclipse. Just paste it here. Okay, and if you look inside it, you can see there's a pom.xml file. So you know it's a Maven project. So in Eclipse, you can import it as a Maven project. Obviously, before you do that, you need to make sure you've got the Maven Eclipse plugin. I've already got it installed in my Eclipse, but if you haven't, you can just go to install new software and then click on add, and then you need the location for it, and you can get it from the web. It's here, Eclipse M2E download, the address here, and then you can just copy this bit here, and then you can put that in the location and give the name for the repository. I don't know, something like M2E releases, and then add it, and then you should find that you've got the plugin available to install. It takes a little while, but then you can just click on it and go to next and install it. But like I said, I've already got mine installed. So then the next thing to do is to import the project. You should have this section here in import called Maven and existing Maven projects. Now that you've got the M2E plugin, go to next and then browse to wherever it was that you put the project. Mine's here, so I'll just select it. Now this might take a while because it's going to look at the POM and might try and sort some things out. So I'm just going to pause it for a second. Okay, so when you can, just click next and finish. And at the bottom right-hand corner, you can see importing Maven projects. Now that might take a while, depending on whether you've got all the dependencies already in your local Maven repository. That's located in your user folder on the .m2 folder repository, and then in there's all your jars. So let's have a look at what the problems are. Six items, errors. Failure. Okay, so there's a few problems that might happen in any of these stages. First of all, you might get a missing artifacts problem. And if you go to this address here, basically it's missing a repository, I think, in the pom.xml file. So you just have to add it. And then sometimes that helps. So this was useful post here, and it's just to add this repository here. So go back to Eclipse, open the POM. And then I like to look at it in this view. There's a problem here. I don't know what this problem is, but anyway, let's add this repository. I'm just gonna put it here. Control A, Control Shift F, just to make it look nice. Okay, That's good. So the problems have gone away. So that usually helps. But there might be another problem. You might get this problem: errors, running builder, Maven project builder, blah, 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 blah. And to solve that, there was an entry on Stack Overflow. I can't remember what it was. Oh yeah, basically, it's because there might be a problem with your local M2 repository folder. So if you get that, it's a bit annoying. You have to go here, select everything here, and just delete it, which will delete all the local jars and everything, which is, and then you have to close down Eclipse and restart it. And when it does, it will try and re-download all the dependencies, and then it will sort itself out. So that might solve the problem as well. And then the last thing is, you might get the project configuration is not up to date with POM XML, but it tells you how to fix it here. You just have to go to run Maven update project. So like right click Maven update project if you have that problem. So those are the errors that you might find, but this seems to be okay now. So to run it, you just have to go to Cineas, right click it and go to run as, and then Maven build. Okay, well, I've already got configuration. Let me show you. The first time you run it, you'll get a run configuration, which is one of these here. It won't run automatically, and you'll be asked to configure it how you want to run it. Now in the pom.xml, let me come out of this a second. Let's go to that view here and go to the end. And in the build plugins, you can see that, minimize this a bit. Yeah, it's using Jetty. It's here in the build section, plugin Jetty. So Jetty is a server that this web app will basically run on. So to run it, it's not as simple as just doing run as Maven build. You have to configure it. So in run configurations, all you have to do is add this bit in here, Jetty colon run in your goals. And then once you've done that, you can click on run. And then again, it might take a little while to download the first time that you do it, because it will need some extra stuff. But eventually you should get a message saying that it started. There we go, started Jetty server, started scanning intervals of 10 seconds. Okay, so this is being configured in the POM so that if you update your code, it, after 10 seconds, it will, you won't have to restart the server, it will just look and sort itself out. So that's quite useful. Where is it? Yeah, the scan interval 10 seconds. Okay, so the Jetty server started. So to run the actual web app, you just go to your the browser localhost on port 8080, so that's colon 8080, and hopefully the Cineas page should come up now. Yeah, there it is. Okay, now it won't have any data yet because it needs to be populated. There'll be some JSON files that'll go in this directory here, and then in your graph database under target, it will update a whole load of things on the index as well. So to get it to like populate, you just need to navigate to /populate, click enter, and then this takes ages. Okay, so if I go back to Eclipse, it should start at some point. Yeah, start downloading them. So here you can see in the Lucene index, there's a write lock at the moment because it's just updating itself. And it's downloading here a load of JSON files, movies and person. So I'm just going to pause this and wait for this to finish. It does take like forever. So, but when it finishes, this page here should change to list some of the movies. Okay. So after a while, the nodes will update here. So you'll know it's done. It won't just be a write lock file. And there will be a lot of movie in person nodes. And if you navigate to the page, you'll see that it will have changed from connecting to a list of movies. And so it's now running. And you can use this to search, let's say, Avatar. And it'll come up and all the details from will come through. So it's all working. I couldn't get to register. I don't know if you need to have some like details, but if you click on register with some new details, it says no element found. So I don't know if that's an error or whether you need to have some kind of login details or, but I thought you would have been able to register, so I couldn't get that to work. And to be honest, there's a lot of it I don't understand because it brings in aspects and tests and things like that. But the main things are here. There's controllers, and there's your domain classes that represent the data, like the actor one, the movie. So it's quite good to have a look around and see how to use the Spring Data Neo4j annotations and whatnot. For example, here it shows you how to annotate this domain movie class with at node entity. So yeah, once you've got it running, it's easier to have a look around. So I hope that's helpful.